just said it. Praise the Lord, everybody. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. My soul shall make a boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. And I'm glad about it. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. Let's give the Lord some praise today. Can we just thank God for the being God? That have believed us in prayer and scripture and welcome and singing until it feels like heaven in the room. We can thank God for the children. We thank you. We thank you for your example. Y'all not scared to get up and do stuff. And I thank y'all for that. It's a blessing. It's just a blessing to be here. And y'all pray with me and pray for me because I'm asking the Lord to lead and guide me and to hold me and to keep me from running off somewhere I don't need to go. But you know, God is so good. Just got to praise him. Just got to praise him a little bit. So I'm just going to talk to the Lord for a minute, and then we're going to talk about something.
All right.
Lord, we thank you for this day, God. Thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for waking us this morning, starting us on another beautiful day. Thank you for your sunshine this morning, God. Thank you for watching over us last night, God. Thank you for watching over us, God. 337 days in 2017, God, you have brought us from January to the first Sunday in December. December, God, we thank you for it. You didn't have to do it, but you did. God, we just thank you for all your many blessings. Thank you for what you've done, what you're doing right now, what you're going to do. God, we give you the praise. We give you the honor. We give you the glory. We bless your name. We magnify you today. We magnify the name of Jesus. We magnify your name, God, because you are great. And you're greater to be praised. And God, we just want to praise you till it feels like heaven in the room. And my room is in my heart. I know when you come in, God, everything changed, God. We just thank you for being here today. Thank you for letting us be in your presence. God, just bless everyone under my voice today, God. Lord, I ask you just to come, Lord, and decrease me. And you increase in me and through me. Lord, I just say you can use me however you want to, God. I ask you, God, to do that thing that you want to do, God. God, I ask you to say the words that you want to say, God. God, just unbutton my lips and loose my praise. And God, just do the thing that you want to do, God. Give us a word today, God. A word we can live on, God. And just a word that we can grow on and a word that we can go on, God. Because we need a word from you today, God. And I thank you for your word. I thank you for your son, Jesus, who went to Calvary. I thank you for my church family. God, I thank you for my family. God, you're so good to us, God. I look out and I see my family. I thank you, God. I thank you. I thank you. Then, Lord, I ask you to bless my mother today, God. You know how she's doing, God. I ask you just to be everything that she needs. Prop her up on every leaning side. God, I know you will. You've been done it all these years, God. And you didn't bring us this far to leave us. Lord, I know we came this far by faith. God, leaning on you, depending on you, calling on you. And Lord, we're going to keep on calling on you. God, we thank you. You're so good. You're so kind. You're so merciful. God, I just want to thank you today, God. Thank you for this opportunity. I thank you for Pastor Hartwell and his vision, God. I thank you for St. Andrew. God, they didn't have to let this happen, but they did, God. And I know, God, you are a great God. You don't do anything that's wrong, God. God, your will be done today, God. Somebody may need deliverance today, God. Somebody may need healing today, God. Somebody may need their soul saved today, God. Somebody may need, God, just peace and joy as we celebrate these holidays. Somebody may not be celebrating, but God, you can come in and give them peace in their heart. You can come in and give them joy. That's what we come seeking you today. We come seeking all that you have for us, all the many blessings, all the gifts that you have for us. God, I thank you today. God, just give us a word. Lord, I ask you just to anoint our hearts and our minds to receive your word, God, and then let us be doers of your word. God, I thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. I say amen. 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 I was thinking about that. You know, God been so good to us. It's the first Sunday in December. He brought us all through this year and all the previous years. But you think about it, we've come this far by the grace of God. He brought us. We've been through some things this year. God been with us though. God brought us through some things this year. We're going through some things right now. But God is with us. He's on our side. And all we got to do is hold on to going to look at Luke chapter 1, verses 30 through 34.
All right.
And Quay has already read the scripture, so I'm just going to tag along. Verse 21, and it said, and she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins.
Amen.
Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, behold, a virgin shall bring forth a child, and shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and she called his name Jesus.
All right.
Then over in Luke, verse 1 and 30 says, and the angel said unto her, fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb, and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. He shall be great. That's why they keep saying you are great. And shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever. And his kingdom, there shall be no end. So that means everlasting.
Amen.
Everlasting kingdom. Yeah. Then Mary asked the angel, how can this be? Seeing I know not a man. The angel said, the Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Highest shall overshadow thee. And that thing which shall be born of thee, shall be called the Son of God. Amen.
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 So we're going to use for a little subject today, call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. Call his name Jesus. And then I'm going to go and pick up a little bit of Isaiah. Isaiah 9 and 6 said, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. So call his name Jesus. You know, Jesus came humble. You know, there was no room in the inn. Now, he had to be born out of the stable, born in Bethlehem. He came as a reject. They rejected him. No room in the inn. And as an outcast, you know, but it was all in the plan. You know, Jesus wanted to come. And he wanted to experience the things that we go through. Sometimes we feel like a reject. Sometimes we're outcast.
Amen.
Whatever the situation is, you might be in a failure. Somebody leave you out because you did something. You got that. They don't want to be with you. But you know, God, he came as to experience everything, so he'll know how we can get through it. But you know, the baby Jesus, he grew up to be about his father's business. That's why he came. Jesus came to seek and to save the lost. And he went about healing the sick and raising the dead, giving sight to the blind. And he came to change lives. That's why he came. So can we thank God for that? Sending his son, he came to save us and to seek us. Not only does he save us, but he's seeking us. That means he's running after us. He's calling us to himself. Paul said that Jesus came into the world to save sinners, whom I am the chief. Jesus, and he came to serve, not to be served. That's how humble he was. He came to do the Father's will. He came to save his people from their sins. So you got to be his. That's why he came. To save his people.
That's right.
So Jesus said in Mark 1:38, he said, let us go into the next town that I may preach there also. For therefore came I forth. He came to proclaim the good news about the kingdom of God.
Right.
So Jesus was preaching and teaching. So we got some good news today.
Right.
You know, I was listening to the news. You know, I'm retired. So at 5 o'clock, I watched the 5 o'clock news. And at 5:30, I watched the national news. But the news started coming on at 4 o'clock. So they on from 4 o'clock to 6:30. I said, oh my God, there's too much news down here. I got some good news.
Right.
Give me 2.5 hours of this good news.
That's right.
It's good news right here. If y'all ain't got no good news, it's the good news right here. Every time you go into it, it's so much. storm. What happens when you call his name Jesus? I want to look at a couple of men that called him over in Matthew chapter 9. Y'all, I just encourage you to search the scripture for yourself.
Right.
Anything I say, you go home, read the scripture for yourself.
Right.
But over in Matthew chapter 9, verse 27, it says that as Jesus went out from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, "Have mercy on us, son of David."
That's right.
When he had gone indoors, the blind men came to him and asked him, "Do you believe that I am able to do this?"
Right,
"Yes, Lord," they replied. Then he touched their eyes and said, "According to your faith, it will be done to you."
Right.
And their sight was restored. Jesus warned them sternly, "See that no one knows about this."
Mm-hmm.
But they went out and spread the news, the good news about him all over the region.
That's right.
Now remember, Jesus had been casting out demons. He had healed the woman with the issue of blood.
That's right.
And then he had raised the Jairus' daughter.
That's right.
And they was leaving. And the blind men called out to him and said, "Thou son of David, have mercy on us." But guess what? Jesus didn't answer them right then. He didn't say anything. He didn't even acknowledge hearing him. He just kept walking. But guess what the blind men did? They couldn't see him, but they followed him. They couldn't see him, but they followed him. They couldn't see him, but they followed him. They had heard the good news. They heard what Jesus was doing. They heard about it. Not only that, but seemed like they had some spiritual discernment because they called him the son of David.
Well,
now, as far as I've read, nobody has called him the son of David so far.
Well,
so Jesus knew they had something. But anyway, they followed him. Mm-hmm. Jesus went into this house. They went into the house too. They kept on. And they went into the house, and that's when Jesus asked them. He said, "Do you believe that I'm able to do this?"
Right.
And they said, "Yes, Lord. Yes, you're able." They believed. They had the faith. You know, it took faith for them to cry out to God. Because normally when the blind were crying out, they were crying out as beggars. We were talking about that in Sunday school. They're begging for money. But these men, two men too. And then God said, when there's two or three gathered in my name, I'll be in the midst. Two blind men. They cried out. It took a step of faith for them to cry out to God, cry out to Jesus.
Right.
They called his name. Then it took more faith to keep on following Jesus. He didn't answer them right away. So that tells me sometimes we got to wait on God.
Right.
He might not answer us right then, but it doesn't mean that he's not going to do what he said he's going to do, because his words are true.
That's right.
All right.
Good word.
You know, and the blind men, you know, they didn't call him Lord, but they didn't call him Jesus. Instead, they called him the Son of God,
amen,
Son of David. And you know, this is important because they had heard about the Messiah was coming.
Right.
And the promised Messiah had been prophesied about in Scripture,
mm-hmm,
and had prophesied that God was going to send a light. And they saw Jesus as this light the world.
That's right.
This light of the world. So think about this. You know, they were blind. They couldn't see Jesus,
mm-hmm,
but they saw him. They couldn't see, but they saw him.
Yeah.
And Jesus, you know how he told the men, "Don't tell nobody."
That's right.
"Don't tell nobody."
That's right.
But they went out, they ran and told the whole region. You know, I was thinking about the football regional, you know, I'm talking about the Southeast region, SEC or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But these men went through the region.
All
that
right.
Means they left St. Andrew and went somewhere.
Right.
They left St. Andrew and went somewhere else. They told somebody else other than St. Andrew.
That's right.
So yeah, God is showing me something in these scriptures. I tell you what, my God. You know, I just thank God. God is so amazing. His word is so amazing. I love God.
Mm-hmm.
I just have to tell you. Yeah, he asked himself, and this question is for us today. Do you believe that God is able?
Amen.
Where are you going through?
Amen.
You?
Amen.
Young adult?
Amen.
Us seniors?
Amen.
Do you believe that God is able?
Amen.
He's able to do what he said he will do.
That's right.
Do what he said he would do.
That's right.
gonna move. Sometimes you just gotta take that next step. But it's a step of faith. Trusting in God. This is what they did. They believed that he could do something to help them. He could do something about that situation. And they didn't hesitate to answer him either. Just like Mary did. Mary didn't hesitate when the angel told her what was gonna happen.
Right.
She
That's
said,
right.
Yes, Lord, be it unto me. And just know that something happens when you call Jesus. Do y'all know that?
Yeah. Yeah.
If you know it, can somebody raise your hand? Yeah. Y'all look mighty quiet to me. Yeah. I see why them preachers be saying that now. y'all know. Do y'all know?
Yeah.
Call his name, Jesus.
Right.
Call his name. Yeah. Oh, anybody in here need a healing today?
Yeah.
Call his name. Anybody in here need a blessing today?
Yeah.
Call his name. Anybody need some joy today?
Jesus.
Call his name. Anybody need some love today?
Jesus.
Call his name. Anybody need some soul saved today?
Yeah.
Call his name.
Yeah.
Anybody got something you need God to take out of you, you know ain't right?
Yeah.
Call his name.
Jesus.
Call the name
Jesus.
Jesus. Call
yeah.
his name.
Yeah.
Call
yeah.
the name Jesus.
Yeah.
We got some good news. Y'all know there's a lot of stuff in the news.
Yeah.
And I guess the Lord just be working with the news.
Mm-hmm.
We got some good news. Let's spread this news. I'm about to make me a TV channel. You can call his name by faith, and it don't take much.
That's right.
The Bible said,